Hey guys, it's Tina Chef here at Rebalance Physical Therapy in Center City, Philadelphia, and on the main lines in Narberth, Pennsylvania. And I am a orthopedic and pelvic floor physical therapist, and our company, Rebalance Physical Therapy, our specialty is working with clients who have spine, pelvic, hip, and pelvic floor issues can include so many different things. You can watch all of our YouTube videos because there's probably 100 different things, symptoms that someone can feel. But today I want to talk to any of you who might have what's called an anal fissure and why this might be happening and how the pelvic floor may be a culprit in that fissure that you might be experiencing. And for those of you who may not know what a fissure is or what it feels like, a fissure is actually a cut or a tear in the anal sphincter of where you obviously have a bowel movement. So what most people will experience is sharp pain on having a bowel movement that could also have some bleeding, bright red blood that's accompanied with having a bowel movement. And so what that does look like is it basically, this is a picture of the sphincter. So if you kind of cut your body in half and you're looking at the sphincter, basically what you can have is you can have this cut or fissure or tearing of some of the musculature in this area. And obviously if there's a cut or a tear, just like any other cut or tear, it can actually cause some bleeding. And what ends up happening is when people start to feel like they want to have a bowel movement, it can cause a lot of pain, especially when the bowel is moving through here. Sometimes the fissure will heal, but because of that bowel movement putting pressure on a newly healed tissue, it can actually open that back up. And oftentimes what happens is you may go see your colorectal doctor or even your primary, and they'll diagnose you and say, yes, this sounds like a fissure, and they'll give you suppositories that you can use to kind of make this area smooth. They can also there's certain medication that's in the suppositories that can help kind of soothe the muscles and things like that to help allow you to have a bowel movement. And this can be very helpful. But oftentimes what we see in our clinic is that patients have these fissures and they do use this and it gives them temporary relief, but then the fissure comes back. And oftentimes what we find is that people, in addition to the fissure, also have a lot of tight musculature in and around their pelvic floor muscles, as well as in and around the sphincter. So what does that mean? So basically, you have muscles inside of the pelvis called your pelvic floor. And I have lots of videos, as many of you who have subscribed to our site probably already know of. You've probably heard more about pelvic floor than you wish to even hear about. But basically, muscles in and around the pelvis, they basically cradle the inside of the pelvis. And as we speak, I'm actually trying to grab a picture of the pelvic floor so that some of you newbies can see. Okay, inside the pelvis, right in through here, these are the muscles of the pelvic floor. And you can see here is the cutout for where your sphincter muscles would actually kind of go down into, okay? But these muscles, when they become really, really tight, can also, in addition, make the sphincter, which is this guy right here, which is also a muscle, make that tight too. And when that is too tight, it's kind of like taking, again, if you're thinking of this as your sphincter right in through here, and these are a bunch of muscles, you're basically making that hole tighter. And when that is tight and taut and it's not soft, you can imagine that something trying to go through, okay, like stool, can cause a lot of pressure on the walls of those muscles. And if these muscles are not supple and soft and can become flexible to open to that stool to allow the stool to pass, then you're going to be hitting against a wall of muscle. And at some point, if you have a bowel movement that really needs to come through, it can tear that muscle apart because it's too tight. And so what we often see is, in addition to the sphincter being tight, you also see the muscles in this pelvic area of the pelvic floor are also tight. And when things are tight, okay, and you can do this experiment at home, take your fist, and I want you to just hold your fist really, really, really tight as hard as you can for like 15 seconds. And you can see when that is really tight, already you're gonna start noticing, wow, that doesn't feel comfortable. And eventually, if you hold this tight enough, it's gonna become painful. And this is exactly what happens in muscles that are tight. When it's tight and things are, you know, stay like this for a long period of time, when you open your hand, you can see that, you know, my hand was kind of white and yellow, but when I released the tension, when I opened up the hand, it becomes pink again, okay? And what happens is when muscles are really, really tight, you're actually not getting good blood flow to that area either. And that was signifying with my hand kind of going white and yellow, but when I open it, you see it turn pink. That pink is the return of blood flow. So when this sphincter and when the pelvic floor are really, really tight, you also don't get half of your blood flow to that area. And when you don't get good blood flow, what does that mean? Nutrients that the blood has to flow into that area to deliver the nutrients that these muscles and nerves and things like that need aren't delivered. And so your body doesn't like that. The tissues, meaning the muscles, don't like that. So that can also prevent healing and good blood flow and, you know, clearing out toxic things in the musculature in this area. So again, in addition to the fissure, okay, if you have tightness in this musculature, that also could be either a potential reason that the fissure is not healing or keeps coming up again, or it could be the reason why the fissure developed in the first place. So it can be one or the other, okay? And so for those of you who might be suffering from this and wondering what else can be done about it, rather than, you know, having to clench my muscles in order to have a bowel movement because it hurts so bad, because again, clenching just contributes more to the tightness that might already be there. So again, it's this vicious cycle, you know, your body's in pain, it clenches because it's painful to have a bowel movement, which then doesn't help the fissure in the muscles either. So you really wanna get this treated as well, in addition to doing all the other things that might be helpful from a interventional medical standpoint, like using suppositories and things like that, eating a high fiber diet, not straining, all those other good things that your colorectal doctor or your primary care doctor may tell you. So what is a physical therapist going to do about this? Well, first of all, you can't just see any old physical therapist. You have to see somebody that really understands how to treat this. Especially you need to see someone who specializes in pelvic floor dysfunction and understands why this could be happening and how it needs to be treated. So if you live in and around the Philadelphia area, or you're thinking of coming into town to see us and be treated for this, then it's a no-brainer. Come and see us, give us a call. We treat in a very holistic, integrative way, meaning there could be other things that might be contributing to the fissure that I couldn't cover all in this video that we may need to also address. But our specialty would really be trying to improve the health of these muscles so that the fissure doesn't hopefully keep reoccurring. So I hope this video was helpful to many of you who might be suffering from these nasty, painful fissures, and that there is possibility of long-term relief. Now, again, if you're coming to visit us, then our website is rebalancept.com. That's rebalancept.com. The website link should be in the description below. And if you live in and around the area and you're concerned about this and you really want to come in and see us, you may qualify for a free phone consult with me or coming in and talking to one of our therapists. And then we have lots of other helpful YouTube videos as well as helpful information on our website. So come visit us and check out all of our other YouTube videos. So I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Take care.